Creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Skull Island, and it's great to have you along for the ride. Now, we have created this 3D immersive experience, so you're going to have your glasses ready. Don't put them on yet, just have them in your hand because we're about to return to Skull Island.
a Volkswagen building. A couple of flying cars from Back to the Future 2 from the futuristic land of 2015. Oh boy, I can't wait for 2015. It's gonna be so flying. Speaking of flying, there's the flying car from Harry Potter. And that pink Chevy Corvette, that is from Angeline. That's a new series streaming on Peacock starring Emmy Rossum. If you're from Los Angeles, you might know Angeline from her billboards in the 1980s. Now, this tank is the Bradley Infantry Fighting Vehicle from Transformers. And it might look pretty rough, pretty rugged, pretty ready for battle, but if I were you, I would not take it into battle. Alright, now these are all real props, set pieces, and picture cars from the original Jurassic Park trilogy. Again, mostly made out of plywood. Not a ton of metal out here. Really just painted to look like metal. Now on our left-hand side, that camouflage-looking vehicle, that is the... Oh, wow, there's some dinosaurs in there. That is the Mobile Lab, and that was hanging off a cliff in Costa Rica. Hang on, did I say that there were dinosaurs in there? Why are they in their cages? Your skin off. Just kidding. All right, now I was talking about that cliff and coaster. You don't usually get a lot of rain. So if they're filming on a parking structure, they gotta make their own rain. That's what we do here in Southern California. We're very lucky to have sunny days, so we gotta make our own rain, a little movie magic. So we're gonna show you a little demonstration of that movie magic as we roll into Old Mexico here. We shoot the rain straight up in the air and we let it fall back down naturally because it looks more realistic to go ahead and turn it. Oh no. Hold on to your valuables. Woo! And that was our flash flood. Should have warned you if you're sitting in a blue seat. Oh, poor Paul. Let me just take him on tour. Now we're rolling through Old Mexico. This is where they filmed Nacho Libre starring Jack Black. Old Mexico to the Old West. Welcome to Six Points. Now, Six Points is one of the most historic locations on our backlot. Do you remember from the beginning of my tour, I was talking about how Carl Lindley used to invite the public onto the sets to watch movies being made, just like we're doing now with you on this trip? He would bring them here to Six Points. Now, Six Points is called that because it used to be six different streets that were six different towns. They each had their own saloon, their own jail, their own...
This location, the afterlife. I've never seen this. You're in the good place.
I'm not supposed to be here. I can't risk going to the bad place.
Maybe it's not all that bad.
Oh, yeah. How can I help you?
What is the bad place like?
Well, it doesn't sound awesome.
Now, Little Europe was also the filming location of Shinobia in Princess Diaries 2, A Royal Engagement. It served as Port Royale and Tortuga in Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl. It was also featured in Cinderella, Roger Scantron's, Scantron's, and Cooper's Cinderella, starring Brandy Lee. up for filming, so pretty exciting. So as we go inside here, just please stay seated for me. The crew is on lunch, so I don't want to disturb what they've set up, so we're going to stay seated and stay inside the trans, but you can see it's all lit. You can see the cameras are set up. Oh, it looks like they've made this into a San Francisco subway station. That's pretty cool, but what we love about the backlog, right, is you can make this a subway station anywhere in the world. Maybe it's a tube station in London. All you got to do is put some poles. Bumblebee from Transformers. I call him Bumblebee because he's a I love a modest celebrity who keeps it real. The use for the shower presser is just unbelievable. Alright, this is of course the set of Albert Hitchcock's 1960 film, The Bates Hotel, and there's the proprietor Norman in the window. He's looking a little